click and move. This movement type is all about point and click navigation. Players simply click on a location and the character moves to that point. This is super intuitive and perfect for games like real-time strategy or certain RPGs. It allows players to focus on strategy and planning rather than manual navigation.
Alright, so to begin, we will create our click and move folder. Then we'll add a scene that will be our player scene. And this will be a character body 2D. Alright, so we'll add a sprite and a collision shape. For our sprite, so we're using the Godot icon. And we're going to scale that to 0.5. And for the shape, this will be a rectangle and we'll just fit it. Then we add a script and we will remove the built-in scripts. Then we'll add an export variable that is speed, 200, and target, which should be vector 2. Then in our ready function, we'll set target to our global position, and the input event is when we click the mouse button, we want to move the character towards there. So we'll set our velocity to the target, which is where our mouse was clicked. And now when we click, we move.
Grid-based movement. This type of movement restricts your character to a grid, moving them tile by tile. This movement type ensures precise control and strategic planning, as each move can be critical.
We start by an export variable speed, then I'll set our grid size to 64 and target position to be initialized as a vector 2. Then we have a variable move win, which we'll call force. So on the ready function, we set our target position to our player position. We set the input maps to up, left, right.
This code basically moves the character towards a position, and it moves it with a particular speed. That position could be what we call our cell.
So right here, I'm going to simulate a grid-based level by drawing a grid on the map. So this code is not really for grid-based movements. It's just a placeholder for a grid-based map, really. So you can pause and look at the code if you are interested in making this. Right, so now let's put our character in that grid map. And now when we move, you see we move according to the grid.
Platformer movement. This is essential for any side-scrolling platformer. Your character can run left and right, jump to avoid obstacles, and navigate through levels. It's all about responsive controls and fluid movements.
So, well, I guess at this point, right now we're creating our folder for the platformer movement. And in the folder, we'll make a scene, the character to the body scene. And as usual, we are going to use our Star Godot as our sprites. And we'll set our collision shape to match the Godot icon. After that, we can rename our player to something better, like maybe platform player. Then we want to save this, and after this, we'll create a script. Then I'm going to use a built-in template. And this built-in template is actually enough for your platformer startup. Everything just works out of the box, but we might have to adjust this. For instance, we can change the UI assets to UI up, so that when we press the up button, we will jump. and let's create a platformer level. And in this, we just set our sprites, the Godot icon again, we just stretch it, and we create a collision shape with a static body, I mean, the collision shape. So the player can collide with this icon, or in our case, the ground. So we instantiate our player, and when we save the scene and run it, you see we fall down and we can move and jump. So yeah, the built-in template for character body 2D is already a great platformer starter. So yeah. Asteroid style movements. Inspired by the classic arcade game Asteroids, this movement type allows your character to rotate and thrust in the direction they are facing. It is perfect for game setting, space, or any environment really. You can pivot, accelerate, and create a dynamic, engaging experience with this style. Don't worry about the file management here. Declare a variable to export variable really, that is the speed and the rotation speed. Then the rotation direction, and in our get input function we will take the input of the player, and in the physics process we will just rotate it times the rotation speed gotten from the player's input. If you're enjoying this video so far, please you can leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already. That will really help me. So I guess we can blast off to the next one. Brotato style movements. Inspired by games like Vampire Survivors, this movement type combines twin stick shooter controls with a top down perspective. Players use one stick or set of keys to move the character and another to aim and shoot in any direction. It's perfect for frantic high-action gameplay, where dodging enemy attacks and strategically positioning yourself is key to survival. Well, again, as usual, character body 2D and our sprites. Alright, so now we'll add a new node, we call that weapon pivot. In the weapon pivot, we'll create a sprite, which should be our gun sprite. So here we're going to just scale it down until it's something we like and position it well at the eye level. And yeah, I think this should be good. Alright, so collision shape, we'll make a small circle at the base. Yep, and then now it's time for us to save and script. So create a new folder for our Brotato style movement. Right, so we are creating the script. And we can get rid of the built-in script. Okay. So on ready, we're going to reference the weapon pivot and the weapon sprite. Then our movement speed and direction speed. So now in our physics function, physics process function, we're going to get the direction of our mouse and the player inputs. And we're going to flip the character and the weapon sprites based on the mouse inputs in this next one. And then we move the player with move and slide. And yep, this works.
Future power hack here. Just to clarify some things, the way the aiming works for this movement type is the weapon pivots is looking at the mouse constantly, and the gun sprite, being the child of the mouse, would be facing where the character pivots is facing towards.
And there you have it, 5 diverse movement types to bring variety and excitement to your 2D games. Whether you're creating a strategic RPG, a fast-paced platformer, or a thrilling twin-stick shooter, understanding these basic movement mechanics will help you craft an engaging experience for your players. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more game dev tutorials and tips. Drop a comment below if you have any questions or suggestions for next videos. Link to GitHub is in the description. Until next time, happy coding and keep gaming.